On the afternoon of July 28, 1984, 140 nations marched into the stadium for the opening day ceremonies of the Los Angeles Olympic Games.
Romania.
One of the teams marching, the 132 men and women from Romania. Two of the team members, Maricica Puica, who will run in both the 1500 and 3000 meters, and Ion Puica, her husband and coach.
It was a very memorable day for all of us. The American public welcomed the Romanian team with so much enthusiasm and affection. I was in the second row on the outside, and people tell me that they recognize me by my blonde hair. For me, it was a double celebration because the next day would be my 34th birthday.
Maricica and Ion Puica prepared for the Olympics in Bucharest. Since their marriage 14 years before, they have maintained a daily training regimen.
I think the most interesting aspect of the publicity before the race was that most journalists wrote only about Mary Decker and Zola Budd. Few people recognized that Maricica had run the fastest 3,000 meters of the year and that Mary Decker's best time was less than 2 seconds better than Maricica's.
Friday, August 10th. 12 runners line up for the start of the 3,000 meters. 4 weeks before, the race had been billed as a duel between Zola Budd of Great Britain and Mary Decker of the United States. The race begins. Mary Decker, capable of winning races by running in front or coming from behind, takes the early lead. Maricica Puica follows in second place. Decker chose to run only this race because the 1500 and 3000 meters, with their qualifying heats, would require 4 races in 4 days. Puica would be the only runner to make it to both finals. At the 200 meter mark, Zola Budd moves into second place behind Decker. Maricica Puica is third.
I felt quite comfortable and was running easily in third place. I didn't feel tired after my 2 days of qualifications in the 3,000 and 1,500 meters. It was fortunate because Mary Decker was running a very fast race. At 800 meters, she was setting a pace close to the world record.
18-year-old Zola Budd is in second place behind Decker. Leading to the games, she was the subject of worldwide publicity. She first gained international fame as a 5'2", 84-pound, 16-year-old prodigy from South Africa who ran barefoot. With South Africa barred from the games because of its racial policies, Budd moved to Great Britain 4 months before the games were to begin. The following month, she became a British citizen and earned a place on their Olympic team.
The leaders, Decker USA and Budd Great Britain.
With 4 laps to go, Joan Hansen of the United States, fourth from last, makes contact with Aurora Cunha of Portugal.
Intermediate time is on scoreboard B.
Out of the turn, Mary Decker on the inside leads. Zola Budd in the middle second, and Wendy Sly of Great Britain moves on the outside third. Maricica Puica fourth, Lynn Williams, Canada fifth. The rest of the field is strung out in single file behind the leaders. Joan Hansen moves closer to the pack. Down the back stretch with 3¾ laps to go, the 4 leaders are tightly bunched together. Before the race, it was predicted that Budd's only chance for the gold medal was to be far enough in front to hold off the finishing kicks of Mary Decker and Maricica Puica. With 1,400 meters left in the race, Zola Budd inches ahead. Behind her, Mary Decker and Wendy Sly. Maricica Puica is in fourth place.
The leader at 2 kilometers, Budd, Great Britain. The intermediate time shown on scoreboard B.
Into the stretch, Budd and Decker make contact. Puica moves between Wendy Sly and Zola Budd to take the lead. Decker makes an attempt to get back into the race. Zola Budd has regained the lead. Her teammate, Wendy Sly, runs alongside her. Maricica Puica is third. With 500 meters to go, Wendy Sly and Maricica Puica pass the tiring Budd. With a little more than a lap to go, the three leaders again pass by the injured Decker. Maricica Puica and Wendy Sly run side by side in the lead. Zola Budd falls farther and farther behind. With 250 meters left, Puica makes her move. Maricica Puica, Romania first. Wendy Sly, Great Britain second. Lynn Williams, Canada third. Zola Budd finishes seventh, just in front of Joan Hansen, the first American to fall in the race. Mary Decker is helped to her feet as the last runner, Agnese Posumai of Italy, approaches the finish. The replay of the fall indicates that the runners were concerned about the possibility of contact well before the accident. Five strides before the fall, they make contact for the first time.
I believe the lack of international experience of both runners contributed to the accident. However, I truly believe that even if the accident had not happened, the result would have been the same.
The victory was a magnificent experience. Of course, the accident was very unfortunate. However, I can tell you that if an athlete is well trained for an event and certain of her race plan, accidents like this should not happen. I realize the shock and pain that Mary felt, but to be honest, I think that I would have tried to continue the race. It would have been so beautiful, so exciting, if she had tried to finish.
Final results of the women's 3,000 meters are now displayed on scoreboards A and D.
Maricica Puica stands on the top step of the victory platform. On the following day, she will receive an additional honor. For then in the 1500 meter final, her fourth race in 4 days, she is in sixth place with only 100 meters left in the race. She finishes third behind Gabriella Dorio of Italy and her Romanian teammate Doina Malinte to win the bronze medal. But on this day, she makes Olympic history. The winner of the first Olympic women's 3,000 meters ever run.